Welcome students, once again to this module on building effective leadership skills. We have had four series of sessions till now regarding leadership. We have had an introduction session. We had a session on importance of leadership for an engineer. We talked about the meaning and definition of leader on the third day. And one more day, we talked about the process and functions of leadership. Now today, the fifth session that we are going to have, we will be talking about the types of leadership and certain classification which has been popular in terms of classifying the leaders as certain types. To be very general, leadership has been classified as formal and informal. As you see on the slide, formal leaders are those where the leader of a work group holds a particular position or a title, such as supervisor, manager, vice president, lead person, team lead. All these are the names which are given to the leadership position. On the other hand, there may be an informal leader. Informal leader is a person with no official title or status. These informal leaders emerge because they have some characteristics that the group members value. So, because they are valued by the team, they emerge as leaders. Kurt Levin and his colleagues did some extensive work and some experiments on leadership decision making way back in 1939, and they came up with three different styles of leadership, a very popularly heard classification. The first style that Levin and his colleagues talk about is autocratic style. The second is democratic style, and the third is the laissez-faire style. We will look into these three different styles proposed by Levin and others. In addition to that, we will also in this whole module, in another day of discussion, talk about two more new styles which are more recently discussed. So in subsequent session which follows the present session, also we will be discussing more in detail about styles of leadership. After that, in yet another module, we will extensively discuss the theories of leadership from several perspectives and approaches. So now let us talk about the types of leadership from the three distinctions made by Kurt Levin and two more that we are going to talk today. You may look at this slide. The first one is the autocratic leadership or the authoritarian leadership. We will talk about democratic, which is also called participative leadership. We will talk about laissez-faire or free rein leadership. In addition to that, we will also be discussing on another day transactional leadership and transformational leadership. Let us first talk about the authoritarian style. This was first described by Kurt Levin, as I have told you. Out of the three key leadership styles that he has talked about, this was the first and foremost. This refers to the kind of leaders who make decisions without consulting anyone else in the team. Please look at this slide. The characteristics of this leadership style: close supervision, lack of input from followers, they do not feel the need, they do not consider it important, complete control with the leader, total authority rested in the leader, and solo decision making by the leader. Now, every style has its own merits and demerits. We will look at this authoritarian style. What are the merits? What are the advantages? What are the plus points of authoritarian style? Now, let us look at the merits and demerits of this style of leadership. Every style has its own plus points, its own minus points, positives and negatives. It may contribute in one way, but it may also hinder the process of leadership in another way, and also the functioning of the organization in another way. So let us look at the authoritarian or autocratic style of leadership functioning and its merits first. It contributes to quick decision making. It is useful and critical in situations where decisions need to be made very quickly and when the organization or the team is under a lot of pressure. It can also be a good choice when the leader is the most knowledgeable. Please note this: the leader is the person who is the most knowledgeable and he is the most skilled person in the group. Under these contexts, an autocratic style of functioning of a leader is helpful. On the other hand, there are also demerits. If overused, this can come off as domineering and tyrannical. Team members may feel unappreciated, unmotivated, uncommitted to the group because their input is never requested. An activity which I have written over here, you can visit YouTube, the site has been mentioned, and see a video on autocratic leadership. You can visit more videos as well and have a better understanding of what an autocratic leadership is. This brings us to the second type of leadership, the democratic leadership. Democratic leadership is also called participative leadership. Once again, it was proposed by Levin. It's one of the three styles that he has proposed. Let us look at the characteristics of democratic leadership style. Shared decision-making responsibilities are seen. Social equality is seen. Creativity is seen. And there is a high engagement from group members. Not only the leader, but the group members are also participative. Hence, the name participative leadership. Once again, even this style has its own merits and demerits. Let us look at the merits of this style first. You may look at this slide. Leaders who exhibit this style are often described as honest, fair, creative, intelligent, competent. And this style of leadership can lead to a great deal of commitment from group members because they typically feel more input being received from them in the group's success and failure. So, their inputs in the group's success and failure make them feel participative in the decision making and thus they have more commitment as well. While democratic leaders accept and encourage team members to offer their ideas and contributions, the leader does retain the final say over all decisions. Just because we are saying democratic leader, that does not mean there is no say for the democratic leader at all. The final decision lies in the hands of the leader. Now, let's come to the demerits of democratic style of leadership. It is not necessarily appropriate. In all situations, this cannot be helpful. Some situations where it may be inappropriate include those where the group members are untrained, when the group members do not have enough skills, they are not trained enough, or where decisions have to be made on a tight deadline. When there is quick decision making which is required, democratic leadership may not be very useful. This brings us to the third style of leadership proposed by Levin, the laissez-faire leadership. This style once again is characterized by certain characteristics. You may look at the characteristics. There is little direction from the leader. There is abundant freedom for group members. Team members are responsible for all decisions and there is a great deal of autonomy involved in the decision making in everything related to the group. And laissez-faire leaders are sometimes referred to as delegative leaders because they delegate the responsibilities to the team members. Rather than attempt to direct and control the group, they hand over the responsibility of leading the group to the team members themselves. So here what is interesting is the responsibility of leading the team lies as much in the hands of group members as it is in the hands of the leader. They are given equal weightage. Once again, even the laissez-faire style of leadership has its own merits and demerits, both advantages and disadvantages. Of course, it depends upon the characteristics and the situation that the group is in. For example, the merits can be when the members of the group are highly skilled and knowledgeable. So, this is relevant to such a group. When the members of the group are highly skilled and knowledgeable, letting them guide themselves can be a great strategy because they are all highly skilled. In such cases, the leader can still offer support and advice when needed, but followers are mostly able to make their own choices. However, there is the other side of the coin too. There may be demerits as well. This leadership style can be a poor choice in situations that require quick decision making. So, it's a poor choice when quick decision making or where the members of the group lack the skills to succeed. When they are not skillful enough, when there is a quick decision making required, laissez-faire is not a good choice. In such cases, team members may be left feeling unsure of what they do because they do not have a leadership which takes tough decisions. Such situations also lead to a lack of accountability, missed deadlines, low commitment to the group. Here is a comparison between autocratic, participative and delegative styles of leadership. You may just look at it quickly. Let us run through it. Autocratic leadership, otherwise known as authoritative, is a leadership style by which leaders have absolute control over a group, make choices and all decisions in the organization based on their own ideas and judgments, and rarely accept any advice from followers. So here the participative role of the followers is very less. On the other hand, participative leadership or democratic leadership is a style that allows and encourages members of the group to share, express their ideas and take a more participative role in the decision-making process of the organization. And finally, the delegative leadership, or also called the laissez-faire leadership, is a type of leadership style in which leaders, by providing tools and resources needed and with little guidance, are hands-off and allow group members to make decisions in their organizations. We come to an end of lecture on day 5. We have talked about 3 main types of leadership as discussed by Kurt Levin and his colleagues. We talked about authoritative leadership, we talked about democratic leadership, we also talked about laissez-faire leadership. We will talk about 2 more recently discussed leadership styles in the next session. So this brings us to an end of day 5 lecture. Thank you.